so exciting to have you all. And there was nobody, her family was the best, the most for her. And of course, Sunny was the world. And he was adorable. So cute.
Was.
And the other thing I remember a whole lot is he loved pinch cheeks. She'd come over and pinch cheeks. And you know how all when he was little, when I would go, ooh,
he must have been a little chubby again.
No, I wasn't actually. That's why it hurt so much. Now it'd be different. But she was always full of life, always ready for fun. She could go into a room and make everybody laugh in many ways. She would make, she was a Kinsenmacher, that was right. Say, whatever. And I remember she came from Israel bearing gifts. I think my sister has a beautiful Bible. Yeah. The silver coated with turquoise stones in it that she brought, and she also brought this, which I have always cherished and always loved. It's a Yemenite necklace, and I'm sure these are very precious stones, as you can tell. But I have always loved them, and it's always been very special. She's been with me.
That's how such a
It's so funny that you say about the pinching cheeks, because Shraga said goodbye yesterday, my 10-year-old, I think maybe to one of you, I don't remember who, and he said, I'm going to pinch your cheeks the way Saba always pinches my cheeks. So it's so funny so that you say that, because it passed down to her son, and now her grandson is also pinching cheeks. It's so funny that you just said that. I didn't know that that's where
maybe
I got it from.
Maybe it's part of
her DNA. I don't know. I'll have to get that checked out.
Ellen, you want to
so
say something?
Just
a couple of things. Just a couple of things. You said enough of the Leviathan.
So January 1st, 1998, you were at my house. I don't know. It was 1998. Okay. Okay. And we taped my mother and my sister.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
My mother
and her sister,
and her sister.
Right.
Rachel.
Right.
And unfortunately, my mother didn't provide very much information. But Aunt Rachel, I just looked at part of it this week. But my Aunt Rachel did still have that dignity that she always had, and the positive outlook. And there's two things that I thought were very interesting. The question was asked, what kind of house did you live in Poland? And both my mother and Rachel said, oh, big, beautiful house, big house. So someone said, maybe more to ask, how many rooms?
One.
Two bedrooms and a kitchen. Big, beautiful, wonderful house, two bedrooms and a kitchen.
Palace.
And this slept with this, and he slept with her, and he slept with them. And And the other thing that I remember,
life was a party.
That struck me from the table. She was talking a little bit about what
children.
Her life was like, but then suddenly her face lit up, as did my mother's, when they were talking about what happens during Shabbos. During Shabbos, all of a sudden, everybody needs to be home, needs to be there for dinner, no matter what you're doing. My mother said that she would get into trouble if she wasn't home for Shabbos to eat dinner together. And
that's
Rachel said that being the youngest, she would walk with her father to synagogue. And I didn't know this, but I know you can't carry things, but I didn't know you could carry a talis. Is that true?
Yeah, it is there.
So she, being the youngest, would walk with her father to synagogue and carry this talis. That was memorable to me. Yeah.
This is what we want to
do. Anybody else?